Today, I'm going to take you through 7 common Excel errors. I'm also going to add a bonus one for you here that you're going to come across at some point and how you can fix them. So one fix is just to get rid of them. But yeah, don't do that. So you don't want broken formulas. You want consistent ones. And if they don't work, you want to understand why and at least fix it in a way that doesn't return an error. Let's take a look. The first error has the easiest fix. When you see values like this, it means double-click to expand the column. Your numbers are too big to be reflected in this short space. That's why you see the hash sign. Excel doesn't want to cut them off because then you might end up reporting wrong numbers. Notice for text, it doesn't do that. It does cut off the text, but it doesn't want to take that risk on your numbers. So just double-click and expand the width of your columns. Number 2. Hash value. The hash value error generally happens when you use the wrong data type. So here, if I had a simple formula that deducted the previous year sales from the actual sales, right now, am I going to get an error when I send this formula down? Just going to double click, send it down. No errors. These empty cells are treated as zeros with this formula. But if I had text here, say if I typed in missing, I'm going to end up with a hash value error. I can only deduct numbers from one another. I cannot have text. Now, there are some inbuilt functions that can handle or ignore text. So if I didn't want to see that hash value error, I can just put this inside the sum function and send this down, and I end up with no errors because the sum function is able to ignore text. Number 3, hash spill. The hash spill error is a new error in Office 365 and Office 2021. This happens when you use a function that spills to multiple cells. So for example, let's say I'm using the unique function here. I'm going to get a unique list of these values, close bracket, press enter, and I end up with a hash spill error. Why? Because my results want to spill, and this is blocking it. We don't want subscribe to block it. This emoji looks even funnier in the formula bar. When I remove this, my formula spills and the error is gone. Next one is the hash name error. Can you guess what the problem is with this function? There is no function that's called add in Excel. The correct function name is called sum. So if you type the function name wrong and Excel doesn't recognize it, it's going to give you the hash name error. To correct this, type in the right name. Next one is the hash ref error. So let's say I'm just deducting these two values from one another. Let's just send this down. Now, at some point, I end up deleting this column. What I end up with is the hash ref error. The column that this formula was based on is now been deleted. This can also happen if you copy and paste your formula somewhere else. If I press Ctrl Z to go back, and this time, not delete anything, instead copy this column and paste it here, I also end up with the hash ref error. This is using relative referencing. The sales column, which is two columns to the left of here, doesn't exist on this grid anymore. I end up with an error. Number 6, hash div error. The hash div error happens when you divide a number with a zero. So for example here, let's say we want to calculate the percentage change to previous year. I'm going to go with actual sales divided by previous year minus 1. When I send this down, two cells end up having an error. The reason for this is I'm dividing this number with a zero. Now technically, I don't have a zero here. Now, if I had a zero, I'd end up with the same thing, but an empty cell used in a formula is treated as a zero by Excel. Now, what you don't want to do is go in manually and remove these, because later on, when you end up getting a number here, no value is going to show up because you've removed the formula. Instead, what you want to do is use error handling directly in the formula. So once you've written your formula and you've sent this down, if you've noticed that this is going to result in errors, you could put it inside a function that can handle errors. There are many different ways that you can do this. You could use an if function and check whether you have empty cells. Or you could use a generic error handling function, which is the if error function. You're going to start off your formula with if error, then is the formula that you had written before, and then the last argument is the value you want returned in case you end up with an error. So in this case, let's say I want to return nothing. I want to return an empty cell, which means I have to put quotation, quotation, close the bracket, press enter, and now check this out. When I send this formula down, my errors are gone, but everything remains dynamic. I'm using the same formula throughout. So if I end up getting a number here, my calculation automatically runs. Number 7, hash NA. The hash NA error is a common error when you use lookup functions in Excel. It happens when your lookup function can't find what you're looking for. So in this case, I'm using the VLOOKUP function. If you want to learn more about VLOOKUP, I have a separate video on this. Link to it is in the cards and in the description of the video. But if you have Office 365, forget VLOOKUP, use XLOOKUP instead. And I have a separate video on that as well. Check it out in the description or in the cards of the video. Now, the reason I'm getting an error for here is that limbo doesn't exist in my customer master data. The correct one is limba. Now, in case you want to flag these errors or you want to return something else, if you get the hash NA error, you can use the IFNA function. This checks for this specific error. Your value here is your formula and what you want returned in case you have an error, let's say is person doesn't exist, close the bracket, press enter, and now when I send this down, instead of getting hash NA, I get person doesn't exist. You can, of course, also use the IFERROR function. IFERROR checks for any type of error, not just the NA error. The NA error only checks for this specific error. So that was my list of common Excel errors and how you can fix them. Which error do you come across more often? And do you use IF or IFERROR to fix it? Let me know in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, as usual, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet. And I'm going to see you in the next video.